Okay, what's up guys? So this is another episode of the story time. This is actually my second time making this video. You guys probably gonna see this. Some of you guys are probably seen this video, but for some reason the audio messed up. It was so weird. So it's gonna suck now. I have to re-upload everything. It's gonna take so long, but whatever. I'll still tell you that guys the story. I don't mind repeating myself. But so the gameplay in the background, just a random gameplay. It was a pretty nice gameplay at the end. Actually the host migrates, so that's when the video is gonna end. So yeah, let's get into the story. So during this actually not this summer, this August, I found a job to hardwood actually. I was doing hardwood. I was working for this one guy that I met through my brother, and it was pretty fun. Like hardwood making those floors was really nice. Like because after you finish the whole floor, it looks so nice. Like you see the finished work. You're like, damn, I did this whole thing. It was really fun. But the first week obviously was kind of like boring. You know what I mean? Not boring, but it gets time to get used to. Like I will get tired so fast. Like, and I would be so sore the first couple days. Like my ass was sore, my legs was sore because you're squatting all the time. Like you're on your knees, like all over the floor, freaking. Like making, you know, hardwood. I'm pretty sure you guys know what hardwood is. It's like, it's not freaking complicated. So yeah, I was working for that guy, and the thing was that he lives in Vancouver and I live in Portland, and basically the warehouse where we get all our material is in Portland. And he would need to drive to all the way to Portland, and everything like matched so perfectly because also during that time we moved to Portland because we used to live in Vancouver before that. That summer we moved to Portland, and for him to go to the warehouse, he would have to stop by my house and pick me up in the morning. And it wasn't really that bad because it was right on the way to the warehouse, so he didn't really care. He just take an exit and then he just picks me up, and what would happen is he'll go in the passenger seat and I'll sit in the driver's seat. So yeah, I would sit in the driver's seat, and that day was so, I mean, okay, let me tell this first. So what he would usually do, he would usually sit in his seat, just listen to music and go through some papers, like work related stuff, or like be on his phone, like listen to like books or something like that. He would, I don't know what he did, but he would just sit on the side. And that day, I was like, the day before, I got so tired from work, and you know, like I didn't really slip in, and I wake up, he gives me a call, he's like, oh, we're gonna work today, there's a job. I was like, all right man, I got ready and all that stuff. And he comes in, he's like, okay, I'm here, I just get in the van, and it's so freaking warm in the van. Like I don't know how people like it for it to be so hot in the van, like in a car. I don't know, maybe I don't remember if it was cold that day or what, but he would always have the heater up so high, not to the point where you're like sweating, but to the point where it's just so warm, like too warm, like, and you just want to sleep. It's like nothing you can do. And me, as I've just woken up like maybe like a half an hour ago, and I'm still kind of sleepy, you know, like if I probably like close my eyes, I'll probably fall asleep like easily. And I'm just sitting there, and he's like, okay, let's go. So we put on a GPS and start driving to the warehouse, and we're just driving, and it's like a typical like traffic on the road. And remember this, it's getting so freaking warm in there. And I don't know why, it's how human bodies work, but I don't know why this happens, but when it's really warm, I'm pretty sure you guys know that you want to sleep. Like it just makes you want to sleep. It gets to the point like where my eyes were like shutting down by themselves, like they are shutting, and I was having problems like to keeping them closed. I mean open. I don't know if any of you guys have experienced that. I'm pretty sure most of you guys did, because we're all like teenagers and we all went through this stuff where you just want to sleep so bad. Like you would be like, dude, if I could sleep on the ground out here, like outside, just lay down on concrete or in grass, you guys would probably sleep if you had a chance. So yeah, I was tired to that point. So we're driving, we're in traffic, and we're just a little stuck in traffic and like in the middle lane. And so it started getting too hot, and I'm like, okay dude, I have to put the heater down. And while he has his eyes closed and he's just chilling there, I just turned it down a little bit, almost halfway down, and I was like, okay, this should be better. Driving for like 5 minutes, sitting there in traffic, and it's like not really nothing happening, you know, we're just sitting in traffic, we're not moving that fast. And I was like, okay, hopefully nothing bad happens. And the heat, it still like has the same effect, even though I turn it down halfway, it's still really hot. I'm like, okay, this is really bad. So I turn it up even like turn it down even lower. So I'm like, okay, hopefully this helps. So I'm sitting there, and it just makes me want to sleep. And you go, everybody knows this, falling asleep on a freaking, when you're driving, is not the best thing ever. So anytime you guys are in that situation, it's better to turn off the heater and just open the windows for it to get a little bit colder in the car. But the thing was, I don't know why I didn't turn off the heater, or I didn't tell him. I don't know if I was scared to tell him. I have no idea what it was. I guess I was too tired and too like sleepy to like even think about. Like I'm so dumb. Like now I'm thinking about it. I could have just turned off the freaking heater. But I don't know. Maybe I couldn't think of it that time. So what happens is, we're in the middle lane, and for some reason, middle lane and the right lane were going so slow, and the left lane was like the cars were just flying by, and I'm like, okay, man, so why is it so fast? And I'm still sleepy. And remember, you guys are probably like, what the hell? You could have just switched to the lane really fast, and that's it. But no, when you're sleepy, you don't think that fast. So I'm like sitting there, and I'm checking the rear mirror. I'm like, I see a semi truck all the way in the back. It was so far back, and I'm like, okay, dude. And then I look back straight and I'm like, after 5-10 seconds, I'm so stupid. I should change the lane right away. After 5-10 seconds, in my head, I'm thinking that his semi truck is moving at the same speed as we are in the traffic, which was us moving in the traffic like 5 miles an hour, and his semi truck freaking flying like 60, 65 miles an hour. So it's a really big difference. So I start turning to the left, like, you know, turn my signal, start turning. And semi trucks, for them to even if they hit the brakes, the whole semi truck is not gonna stop. Those are freaking, they're huge and they have so much weight, it's not gonna stop right away. So even if you would have hit brakes, it would not ha nothing would happen. So basically, I start switching the lane, and guess what? I was so sleepy. I didn't check my rear mirror again, and he was already by me, because I forgot to, as I told you guys, I didn't think about how fast he was going. And so as I start turning the lane, he just hits the horn, and it was so freaking out, like beep. It was so loud, like it seriously woke me up, like for the rest of the day. And that semi truck just seriously just flies by on the left side. You know, on the left side and the right side, there's like a little area where if you get pulled over, you can stop over there, or if your car broke down, you can stop over there. So basically, that's where the semi truck just flies by, and he just horns, freaking hits his horn so loud, and my boss just jumps off of freaking the seat. He was like, "What the hell happened? What the hell happened?" And he says the semi truck, and he got really upset. He got really mad, and I mean, of course, I understand. We almost got killed over there. I mean, I don't know who wouldn't get mad. So yeah, guys, I almost got freaking taken out by a semi truck, and that's not the best thing that, and I mean, not the thing that you would want to happen to you, to get hit with a semi truck going 60 miles an hour, because that semi truck seriously could have ended my life and his life, and that could have been the end of me. I probably wouldn't never started YouTube, because I actually started doing YouTube after that. So yeah, guys, like, it's a crazy life experience. I got so close. Please never make the same mistake, guys. Just turn off the heater, roll the windows down, and never drive when you like feeling sleepy, or like just make it cold in your freaking car or something. Just don't drive while you guys falling asleep. So that's basically the moral of the story. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Drop a like. Let's go for 5 likes. Let me know if you guys enjoyed this series, and we're coming to the end. Yeah, let's go for 5 likes, guys. It's not that much. I know you guys, if you guys all made it all the way to the end, you obviously enjoyed the video, and peace out.